One of the tensions that I often experience as I spend time with individuals and families is that sort of the culture of cancer is very much you need to be positive, you need to fight cancer, cancer can be beaten. And so to recognize that and be a part of that, and yet at the same time, people don't live with their heads in the sand. And as their cancer advances and as you know they're informed that the treatments haven't been effective in curing the cancer and it's moving forward, it can be a real point of tension, and the individuals feel very compelled to keep this front face of being positive, and their family members want them to remain positive, because there's also, not always, but often a sense of if you're not positive, that's going to work against you. And so certainly want to be a part of that strength and that force against the cancer. And yet, inside, they know that things are changing. And they do have those questions. And so when I think about well-being and what is often very critical in terms of being a part of people finding their way forward, even with a diagnosis of cancer that can be treated, it is that opportunity to look at, you know, what does this mean to me, the fact that I've been diagnosed with cancer? What does this mean for my life going forward? What does this mean for my family? And a lot of those worries and concerns and having an opportunity to talk to those, as well as the hope for treatment. And we still tend to often, I think, polarize. It's either you're here and you're all positive, or you're here and you're all negative. And yet I find in most of us there's that mix. We hope for good outcomes, but there's still the fears often around, what does this mean for me? And so it's all interwoven. It's not two sort of polar opposites, in either you're in one camp or the other.